Could be, who knows, there's something to...
What makes a good producer is somebody who can do that, who knows how to prepare something for a record, who runs a tight ship, that is, say, since time is of the essence in a studio, things have to be done quickly. At the same time, he doesn't sacrifice quality. That's the important thing. If it's necessary to go into overtime and pay extra money, they will do. Goddard would do that. Tommy would do that. But they're good enough so that that doesn't often happen. And because he has worked out the sessions, so he knows exactly how much music each three-hour session can encompass, because they're usually three-hour sessions with the orchestra. And then the other thing is not to convey tension. The cast is tense enough. They know this is their only shot at it. They know they're not going to get, as popular artists do, 56 takes on each song. They know it's very few takes on each song. And they want to be heard at their best. So there's a tension in the air from the beginning. A good producer keeps things not only moving, but light. That is not true of all producers. Some producers convey their own tension, and there's a crackle in the air that's not happy. And I've had that on a number of records. Starting here.